So we all know to get to new levels, we have to be focused on raising our standards every single day. Otherwise, we slowly regress. The reason for this is there's a universal law known as entropy, and it's constantly working against us. Entropy is the law that says everything around us is moving from an ordered state to a disordered state. So think about what happens when you don't clean your house. Your life goes out of order. That's the law of entropy at play. I'll speak more about this in a minute and how we can use it for our benefit rather than our detriment. When we come to the end of our lives, the only thing that we can really take with us are the things that are most important to us. It's things like memories with the loved ones we've created while we were here. It's the experiences we had as human beings and the love that we have for our friends, our family, and most of all, our children. And yesterday I had the extreme privilege to go to a matinee movie with my friend Josh and his two little daughters. So picture this, two bodybuilder type guys, me, my friend Josh, and two little blonde girls, 6 and 8 years old. They were static. At one point, Josh pulled me aside for a minute and he said, "Brad, you know, sometimes I have to pinch myself because my life that I created is just so amazing." A self-proclaimed father by default, he said he wouldn't have it any other way. And it was just one of those like really special moments where time kind of like stood still. And I suddenly realized how on purpose my friend Josh was. And it just reflected off on me and gave me the inspiration to do this video. As far as entropy is concerned, the theory goes is there was a Big Bang. And depending upon your religious beliefs, the Big Bang itself could have been God or Jehovah or Buddha or the organizing intelligence or whatever you want to call him or her. Through that Big Bang, everything started to expand outwards. Through space and time, as expansion happened, gas started to bind together through gravity. And as everything continued to spin outwards, the stars and planets began to form, and the elements binding together like a giant colorful cyclone swirling out of control. This energy expansion was so intense that it melted rock to the earth. And as it cooled, it became the planet you live on today. Through very careful balance and ecosystem, we began to have biology, and life began to form. So the basic core definition of what you are comes from energy exploding outward. Everything you know, hear, touch, taste, or smell comes from expansion. Nature, in and of itself, is expansion. Even for our lives, right down to the core of our being, is to not only procreate and have children and pass our genes on, but also to expand. As soon as we stop expanding, we go against nature herself and we begin to die. We're either evolving or we're dying. We're either moving upward or we're falling. And there is no in between, my friend. Along with this law of entropy and expansion is the law of cause and effect. Cause and effect says that every single action you take has an equal and opposite reaction. So it's no secret. The choices you made in the past determine where you are today. And the choices you make day to day now determine your outcomes in the future. Also, there's another choice you make every single moment you may have overlooked. It's the choice where you direct your attention, your focus. Every single moment that goes by, you have a choice to either pay attention to something that empowers you or something that disempowers you. The quality of your life really has nothing to do with what happens to you. It's how you interpret those moments. So the quality of our lives really has nothing to do with large homes, nice cars, or any type of status or anything like that. I mean, I know many people who are incredibly successful by society's terms, but are miserable deep down inside. Right now, you can either choose to believe life is out to get you, or choose to believe that these challenges are stepping stones to get you where you want to go. The choice is yours, my friend. We'll see you next time.